Good afternoon to all. Today we are going to discuss about measurement skills. Sometimes these skills are called as skills of measurement or levels of measurement. Now let us start with the concept of measurement and scaling. In research, the obtained data may be qualitative and or quantitative in nature. The data consists of quantitative variables like price, income, scales, etc. and qualitative variables like knowledge, performance, character, etc. The qualitative information must be converted into numerical form for further analysis. This is possible through measurement and scaling techniques. Measurement. Measurement is the process of observing and recording the observations. It is also called as data that are collected as part of research. This data may be in terms of numbers or other symbols to characteristics of objects according to certain prescribed rules. Thus, measurement is a process of associating numbers or symbols to observations obtained in research study. These observations could be qualitative or quantitative. Qualitative characteristics can be counted and cannot be computed. Therefore, clear-cut understanding must be needed about the type of characteristics or variable before collecting the data. The rules for assigning numbers must be standardized and applied uniformly. This must not change over time or object. Scaling. Scaling is the assignment of objects to numbers according to a certain rule. In scaling, the objects are text statements, usually statements of attitude, opinion, or feeling. Levels of measurement or scale of measure is a classification that describes the nature of information within the values assigned to variables. Psychologist Stanley Smith Stevens developed the best known classification with four levels of scales of measurement: nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. Stevens proposed his typology in a 1946 science article titled On the Theory of Scales of Measurement. Levels of measurement scales. The level of measurement scales refers to the relationship among the values that are assigned to the attributes, feelings, or opinions for a variable. There are four levels of measurement, namely nominal scale, ordinal scale, interval scale, and ratio scale. Yeah, now come to very first scale of measurement, that is nominal scale. Nominal scale is the crudest and simplest among all measurement scales. The different scores on a measurement simply indicate different categories. It does not express any values or relationship between variables. It is often referred to as a categorical scale. The assigned numbers have no arithmetic properties, like less than or greater than, plus, minus, multiplication or division, and act only as labels. The only statistical operation that can be performed on nominal scales is a frequency count. Few examples: gender, female, male, other; nationality, Indian, American, Russian, Pakistani; ethnicity, German, Spanish, Han Chinese, Arab, Irish; religious preferences, Buddhist, Muslim, Jewish, Christian, or other; language, Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, English, Urdu, other; genre, poetry, drama, fiction, and non-fiction. In grammar, the parts of speech, noun, verb, preposition, article, pronouns, etc. In biology, the taxonomic ranks below domains that are archaea, bacteria, and eukarya. Now, have a brief look on nominal scale. A system of assigning number symbols to events in order to label them. It simply describes differences between things by assigning them to categories. We have already discussed few examples of nominal scale. Now take few more examples of this. Assignment of numbers of basketball players from 1 to 9. Now, in the game of basketball, just for the sake of identification of players, the numbers are assigned to them right from 1 to 9. Here we can't say that the number given to the player, that is 1, is the best player of that team, and the last number that is 9, that player is not that much important. Another example, marital status. Single 1, married 2, widowed 3, divorced 4. Similarly, 0 for no and 1 for yes. These numbers have no quantitative value. Measures of central tendency can be used is the mode. No measures of dispersion can be used. Non-parametric statistical techniques can be used is chi-square. Measures of correlation, coefficient of contingency. It indicates no order or distance relationship and has no arithmetic origin. Now second scale, that is ordinal scale. Ordinal scales involve the ranking of items along the continuum of the characteristics being scaled. Items are classified according to whether they have more or less of a characteristic. The main characteristics of ordinal scale is that the categories have a logical or ordered relationship. This type of scale permits the measurement of degrees of difference, that is more or less, but not the specific amount of differences, that is how much more or less. Here the difference is, in first scale, the things are divided in 2 or 3 or 4 parts just on the basis of some characteristics. Now here, the things are divided in 2 or 3 or 4 categories on the basis of some difference. The difference is less than or more than. This scale is very common in marketing, satisfaction and attitudinal research. Examples of this scale, dichotomous data. We can divide health in sick versus healthy. Judgments in courts, guilty versus non-guilty. Truth value, wrong or false versus right or true. Non-dichotomous data. The Likert scale, strongly disagree, neutral, agree, strongly agree. High school class ranking, 1st, 9th, 87th, etc. Socioeconomic status, poor, middle class, rich. Time of day, town, morning, noon, afternoon, evening, night. Political orientation, left, center, or right. Now in nutshell, places events in order, but there is no attempt to make the intervals of the scale equal in terms of some rule. Only permits the ranking of items from highest to lowest. Ordinal measures have no absolute values and the real differences between adjacent ranks may not be equal. Only can be said that one person is higher or lower on the scale than another. Example of this scale, if one mineral can scratch another, it receives a higher hardness number, and on Mohs scale, the numbers from 1 to 10 are assigned respectively to top, gypsum, calcite, fluorite, apatite, feldspar, quartz, topaz, sapphire, and diamond. With these numbers, we can write 5 is greater than 2 or 6 is less than 9, as apatite is harder than gypsum and feldspar is softer than sapphire. But we cannot write, for example, 10 minus 9 is equal to 5 minus 4, because the difference in hardness between diamond and sapphire is actually much greater than that between apatite and fluorite. The greater than symbol in connection with ordinal data may be used to designate happier than, preferred to, and so on. Thus, the use of greater than or less than can be used without our being able to state how much greater or less. Measures of central tendency can be used are mode and median. Measures of dispersion, a percentile or quartile measures. Measures of correlation, rank order method. Measure of statistical significance, non-parametric methods. Next scale is interval scale. Interval scale is a scale in which the numbers are used to rank attributes such that numerically equal distances on the scale represent equal distance in the characteristic being measured. An interval scale contains all the information of an ordinal scale, but it also one allows to compare the difference or distance between attributes. Interval scales may be either in numerical or semantic format. These are the examples of interval scale. Few other examples of interval scale are Celsius temperature, Fahrenheit temperature, intelligence scale, that is IQ scale, time on a clock with hands. The intervals are adjusted in terms of some rule that have been established as a basis for making the units equal. It may have arbitrary zero but no absolute or true zero. Therefore, it does not have the capacity to measure the complete absence of a trait or characteristics. Example, Fahrenheit scale, in which an increase in temperature from 30 to 40 degree involves the same increase in temperature as an increase from 60 to 70 degree. But one cannot say that the temperature of 60 degree is twice as warm as the temperature of 30 degree. Here, the zero on the scale is set arbitrarily at the temperature of the freezing point of water. In addition to setting up inequalities, we can also form differences, means less than and greater than is there. We can add, we can subtract. These things can be performed in interval scale. 100 degree is greater than 70 degree. 95 minus 70 is equal to 135 minus 110. Mean, that is arithmetic mean, median and mode can be used as a measures of central tendency. Measures of dispersion, standard deviation and range. Measures of correlation can be used is product movement. Measures of statistical significance, t-test and f-test. Now the last scale, that is ratio scale. Ratio scale is the highest level of measurement scale. This has the properties of an interval scale together with a fixed, that is absolute zero point. The absolute zero point allows us to construct a meaningful ratio. Ratio scales permit the researcher to compare both differences in scores and relative magnitude of scores. Examples of ratio scales are weight, height, sales figures, ruler measurement, income earned in a week, years of education, number of children. In a nutshell, ratio scales have an absolute zero or true zero of measurement. This is the only scale which is having absolute zero. The zero point on a centimeter scale indicates the complete absence of length, height. But an absolute zero of temperature is theoretically unobtainable and it remains a concept existing in scientists' mind. The number of incorrect letters in TypeScript, it has absolute zero and all typing errors can be assumed to be equal in significance. One can make statement that A's typing performance was twice as good as that of B. Here, ratio is involved and facilitates comparison. Measures of physical dimensions such as weight, height, distance, etc. We have already discussed about it. In addition to setting up inequalities and forming differences, we can also form questions. Means less than, greater than, plus, minus, multiplication, division, all the mathematical operations, basic operations can be performed on this scale. Measurement of central tendencies, geometric and harmonic means, in addition to the mode, median and arithmetic mean. Measures of dispersion, coefficients of variation. In short, all parametric statistical techniques are usable with ratio scales. Researchers in physical sciences, the advantage to describe variables in ratio scale form, but the behavioral science are generally limited to describe variables in interval scale form. Now, few exercises. The answers are given on next page. So, you may go through the question number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and A. The answers are given like this. So I hope this video will help you guys to understand the scales. One thing I would like to submit here, in statistics, these scales of measurement is very important concept. Based on this, we can decide which kind of statistics will be used while analyzing the data, where to use parametric statistics, where to use non-parametric statistics, which kind of correlation is used on which data, or where to use t-test, where to use another kind of statistics. So to understand the very nature of data is too easy if we understand the concept of measurement of scales. Thank you.